About Meghan and what this means. So Meghan and I got our tears out on the way over here today. At least I think we did. When she was young, we would always talk about her wedding. We'd think about this day. And we even did a few simulations of this day, if you can believe that. We would, you know, she would go through all kinds of different things. And then the Lord started speaking to me and said, you know what? This isn't about you. This is about her. Tears of joy for her. with a fine young man that she's met, Jane, what he means for her, and what a great life they're going to have together. I couldn't ask for a better son-in-law. The relationship of a father and a daughter is unique and special in its own right. You being born was one of the greatest joys in my life. I truly enjoy being your dad. As I reflect, I hope Mom and I have led you well, modeled you well, for you well, and most importantly, loved you well. Brother and I started praying at a very young age for you. That we're thrilled to you guys getting to start your life here. What comes along with that, though, I'm going to pass on to you, the car repairs, the oil changes. I'm going to quote a saying, and I hope you'll take this to heart. This is what Grandpa would have said if you were here. So when faced with a mountain, I will not quit. I'll keep on striving until I climb over, find a pass through, tunnel underneath, or simply stay and turn that mountain into a gold mine with God's help.
Unless you don't know me, I would say we got along pretty well when we were younger, but we had our moments. As we got older into high school, we got closer because we were together all the time. Nearing the end of high school, I was realizing that Meg and I's lives did not just include the two of us anymore. Someone else was coming around pretty often, and that person was Jamie. Once Meg started dating Jamie, though, I saw a completely different side of her. He truly brings out the best in her. Some qualities I noticed in Jamie was his ability to make Megan smile. And finally, he loves the Lord. Meg is an empathizer, and a sympathizer. She truly puts herself in your position when you're going through something and wants to go through. Finally, she is the most selfless person I've ever met. But I will especially miss having you just right across the hall to talk to. I will miss your older sister's advice and your hugs that I say I need so much. One of the people who can't be here with us today. To always talk about Jamie Duvic, what it would be like, and how he couldn't wait, and how he had to agree with this boy. Thankfully, he did get to spend some time with Jamie, and I would say he did first. I love you both very much. I'm not a happy person, and I wouldn't give him a hug until he became my brother-in-law, so.
Some say that I helped put them together. I have to take too much credit.
You're welcome.
My dog, Jamie. Jamie, he's a little friend. He's a hard worker. He's got this gentle and kind spirit. But you know, we pulled a lot of pranks, so I figured he would know that I was joking when I said he should become a part of the family. I remember the night I called him, I was like, hey, where you at? And he's like, my Megan, and he's exactly there. There's no one I'd rather throw a meal for than my best friend. Megan is legit one of the sweetest people I know. I love these two so much individually, but I love them even more together.
No need, no vacation, no fancy destination. Baby, you're my great escape. We can stay at home, listen to the radio, dance around the fire. If I never get to build my mansion in Georgia, I'd drive a sports car up the coast of California. Oh, if all I got is your hand in my hand, baby, I could die a happy man. Baby, I could die a happy man. Toes, I like your soul, baby. You got that heart made of gold, baby. I'm gonna love you till I'm old, baby. I just wanna be your baby. I like your soul. I like your soul. I like your soul.